What's going on, Crossfire fans? It's high time I made another video. I've been requested to throw one up to kind of give an account of some of the things I've done so far. So I'm going to start from the inside out of the car, and hopefully I can spend enough time with each feature that you guys will have all the questions answered that you've been asking me up until this point in the build. So I'm going to start off by going to the iPad, because that's probably one of my favorite installs. It took a little while because we had to find the right size iPad as well as making sure that it fit flush. So there it is. It's in there. It's up and running. Just going to turn the key and show you that it does work and play some tunes. So that does work. I know not exactly the coolest of tracks, but let's see. I know exactly what I gotta play. I gotta throw something up for the heads. Give me a second. All right. I think this song is appropriate.
Yeah.
All right. So there's the iPad. Now, I've thrown a video up with the iPad before. I didn't have the feature I'm about to show you hooked up at the time, so I'm going to do that right now. It's one of my favorites. Just going to go ahead and start the car. Okay, it's a program called Dash Command. And this is it here. And what I like about this this particular app is that, as you can see, it gives me a bunch of information in regards to what's going on with my car. Let's turn this down a little bit. So again, you can see it's got all the features for diagnostics, vehicles, so on and so forth. And if I hit each one, now there's nothing in there now because I haven't really been using it, but some of these will show you some information like my performance, because I have been using those. Okay, but the one that I like the most is the one I'm going to key in now, which is the speedometer view, which allows me to literally turn my iPad into a speedometer. And I'm going to show you. That's not the one I want. Give me a second here. Let's try that again. Okay, this is the one I want. And this is the one that I use probably the most. One, because I like the way it looks, and two, because it's a full feature gauge, as you can see. It takes up the whole area. Looks pretty nice. And it's in now. You can see when I rev that it does work. There's probably a slight delay, but it's not enough that it's bothersome. It works just fine. I'm not gonna go far here, but I'll just put it in gear and drive a little bit so you can see that it does work. And you can see as it gets faster in speed, the digits actually change color. I hope you can see that. Let's put that in reverse. So you can see that that does work. Okay. Now, as for other interior features, I've finally converted all my interior lights to LED. I don't know how those will show up, but normally those would be a yellowish glow. You can see now they're white. And as I go to the glove compartment, you can see that's white as well. All my lights are LED now. And I'm actually gonna go out of the car now. Oh, by the way, I also relocated the switches. I showed that in another video also. It looks dirty. It's just the way black shows up. I like it, but I'm probably gonna change it. I'm considering covering the whole thing in leather just because it'll wear a little bit better and may add a little bit of, I don't know, an upmarket look, if you want to call it, more sophisticated, exotic look to the car, which is what I'm after anyway. So next season, that's what I want to do. Right now, you can see one of the features I don't like about our Crossfires is the fact that they really cheaped out on some of the interior materials that they used. Like, this was basically really hard, cheap plastic. Now, at the time, it wasn't a big deal, but in order for them to cut corners, I guess, cost-wise, that's one of the things they had to do. And right now I'm getting a lot of, you know, kind of rippling effect of here where I put my arm all the time, which I don't really like. So again, I'm going to be covering the whole interior, steering wheel included, possibly even the gear knob, and most likely the console. I haven't figured out what I'm going to do yet. I have a few ideas in mind, but by the time I'm ready to do that, I'll definitely throw up a vid. So let me just turn off the tunes because I want you to hear the exhaust. I've made another video with the exhaust, but it didn't really come out that great. I was told it's because I held the phone too close to the exhaust. So I'm in the inside of the exhaust now. We're gonna see if you can hear this. And it may even sound a little bit different than it did in the last videos, because in the last videos I had no resonators, and I found that I was losing torque down low. So we ended up putting three resonators in, actually in the exhaust, which I'll show you in a second. And that definitely brought my torque back, but it also changed the sound a bit and created more of a, I guess a more high-pitched trumpety sound. Still like the sound, it's just different. It was much throatier before. It's still throaty, but again, the compromise is worth it. I'm not getting as much drone now that I had the resonators. And again, I've got the lost torque back. Now later on, I do plan on possibly doing an engine upgrade next season. I'm about 95% of the way there. I just have a few other things I wanna do first. And then at that time, I'll be able to remove the resonators and most likely increase the exhaust size. I went up to a 2.5-inch diameter exhaust, stainless steel. I'm probably gonna go to a 3 or even more, depending on what the sound is like later on, if everything works well with the 8-cylinder SWAT, which is what I have planned for next season. So a few more revs. That's at about 4,000 RPM. This is about 3. And I'll just close the door so you can hear what it sounds like on the inside. So it sounds nice. I'll have to find a way to do a driving video where someone else holds the camera so you can see what it's like at highway speed. There is a slight, I have to admit, bit of drone at around 3,000 RPM when I'm on the highway. It's not annoying, but it is there, and it is a little bit noticeable. But as far as to the trade-off, I'm fine with it because I've got that aggressive sound that I want. Just gonna step outside the car now. A few more rests for the fans. All right, and we'll start talking about some of the other things I've done. So obviously I've upgraded the wheels. I've got some Rotiforms. They're 20x10.5 in the back and 19x8.5 in the front. For those guys wondering about the offset, I ended up using 50 millimeter spacers at the back, and I believe it's a 22 offset at the back, and the front's 33 or 34, something like that. But I've got the stance that I look when I go to the side, which is what I want. It's flush with the body, as you can see, or hopefully you can see. And when I come this way, the one things I don't like with Crossfire is when you upgrade the wheels is you get that big gap at the back, and I was able to get rid of that. As you can see, it's pretty tight. Finger-wise, I think I can get one index finger, just a little bit more than one index finger. Let me say 1.25 index finger in there, which is nice. So I have no rubbing issues, but I still get that nice tight look. I think that's as low as I really need to go as far as to the look that I was after. As far as my skirt kit, they're all custom made using an aluminum composite. It's kind of a mixture of a special plastic as well as aluminum. So it does flex slightly, but it's very firm, rigid, very strong. Had those cut. I want to thank Richard from WRAPID for cutting and fitting these, and Elijah from Wired Ridez for spending time installing this with me, because I couldn't have done it without them at all. Again, they're custom, but these wings here from DevSport I ordered separate and then added to that to get that look that I was after. So if I just back off, you can kind of see how that looks. Sorry if I'm shaking, it's a little windy out here. And again, I'll just do a slow walk around of the car so you can see what my new part of the install, which is the rear lip, looks like. Let's get down low. Hopefully you can see that. And I tried to get it to flow into my diffusers. Get the look I was after, and you can see how that looks. So I'll just back off a little bit. And again, walk around the car and see my exhausts. Here at idle, it's got a nice little rumble to it. Step around the car. Okay, and again, that is a wrap. It's Pearl Bahama Blue. It's a slightly different wrap material, a little thinner than most, but it gives a much more realistic paint look.
And again, there are a few guys saying that wraps aren't done well. It depends on who you go to. Mine's really clean. I'll open the door and you can see that the cut lines again are really, really clean. I've done this before, but I'll do it again. So you can see again on the inside, all nice clean cuts. At the time, I didn't do the inserts. Now I have. Okay, and I'll close that up and then I'll walk around the front. And you can see my new CFR logo, Crossfire Racing. That's what it is. Don't get it twisted. And I don't know if you can catch it on the inside. I've got my color matched brake calipers and lug nuts. Big shout out to Need Wings, you know what it is. Backing off, and I'll just come around the front, and you can see that my DRLs are on when I start the car. Hope you can see that. And just down here, you get a look at that. And I've got my lens colored, driver's lights in yellow, for a little bit of a old school feel. Okay, I'm also gonna show you my other LEDs that I've done. I found with my new DRLs that when it's bright outside, that the sun would wash out the indicator color. So I had to add some brighter LEDs on the inside. So I'm gonna do that right now. Just push my hazard, and when I go back outside, you'll see that they're very, very visible. At least I hope you will. Just walk around, and you can see corner LEDs are on. Again, I don't know how bright you're getting this because it's pretty sunny outside right now. Driver's lights are on. Now my headlights look like they're blue. They're actually white, just the way they're showing on film. But you can see here the outline